यार थोड़ा ब्लैक ब्लैक थोड़ा कम लग रहा है यार।
ये कौन दिस साइड है? सुन ये पीछे दो दो के साथ दो आगे दो
हाथ पे दे पूरा। तो कपड़े वपड़े भी चेक कर ले यार।
सब सो रहा है।
मेरा मेकअप मैन तो सबसे पहले सोते हैं रात को।
पीछे 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 पीछे
पिंजाम 17 टेक टू
एक्शन।
हेलो सिंह एनएम की संभालो। कॉल कैब एंड मूव मूव
करेक्ट
एक्शन नंबर वन नंबर टू नंबर थ्री। Action number one, number two, number three.
Probably the first time you're playing a.
Yeah, I have played tough roles, but they've not been true stories. Here I'm enacting the role of my real life, my hero. I mean, I'm talking about the men from the army who die for the country, do everything for the country, who even today are living their life at the border, and none of us know what they are going through. So that is why this role for me is very, very different from the other tough roles. And here again we are showing that it's not just one man that creates an army, like in a regular Hindi film where Sunil Shetty is the hero and bingo, he goes around vamooshing 100 of the villains. Here it's an entire army that makes a difference. It's only because this lot stuck together that they fought the battle. They stayed up all night, fought more than 3,000 people, 50, 60 odd tanks. It was these 90 people who did it because they were a team. They were an army, they were one unit. And that is one of the main reasons this film is very, very different. It's real again. You know, I know I'm playing a character who's done maybe much more than what I am doing in the film. I mean, gave his life for his country in a way we can't even imagine.
Obviously, in doing the research for this film, you've come across a lot of, met a lot of people in the army, etc.
Yeah.
Have these encounters changed you in any way?
Definitely. Lot more respect for the army, for the people involved, and even though they are not fighting a war now, it's like war for them every day. I mean, the kind of routine they go through, the kind of life they are leading at the border. I mean, shooting here itself for 20 and 25 days, you know, makes us think of home and food and the comforts, which we are used to anyways. But 25 days I'm away and I'm missing all that. And suddenly I realize, okay, these people go through this every day of their life, yeah, and they deserve more than what they are getting right now. And I think this film will bring about that awareness. This film will make the youngsters of today, who are not aware about what the army is, it'll make them realize such things. And not only women, children, men, but even the ladies, the women audience will love a war-based film, because there's tremendous amount of emotional. And I think this is the first time where the women will realize that apart from the Saudi borders, there are other borders too, you know. And yeah, that's what's going to be very, very interesting. And I can promise that. I can promise that this film is going to be different and very, very, very different.
And you once made a remark that this film makes you proud to be an Indian.
Definitely. Proudly Indian, as we all say. Definitely. I love being associated with this film. When anybody asks me about my role, the only thing I say is I'm not interested in knowing what my role is. The only thing that interests me is that Sunil Shetty is a part of border. That's all. I don't care whether, even if the length of the film increases and eventually my role has to be cut, it doesn't matter to me. As long as I am present in one frame of this film, it's okay. I've learned so much more, I've met so many people. I mean, it's been a different experience altogether. And even when we give the war cry, whether it's Harar Mahadev or anything else, you can feel it within you when you're with the army. You know there's nobody across. It's not the enemy that is there. We're just enacting this whole thing. But I get the goosebumps. I get the feeling when I am enacting this role too. I think it's simply awesome.
This is your first film with JP.
Yeah, definitely.
Any comments? I mean, how was your experience? I mean, everything else was different. How was...
JP Datta is a fantastic man to work with. Before I worked with JP Datta, everybody said ki he's strict and he screams and he shouts and boy is he strict. But after working with JP, I've realized ki he's a man who loves his work. He's a man who puts in 100% of himself into his work. And so naturally when he sees the others, I mean, what I mean by is a few of them who do not put 100% of the same, he gets cheesed off. And I feel I'm likewise too. Even in my work, if I put in 100% and I expect everybody around to put in the same amount of effort. So I have understood him and I'm enjoying working with him. I would love to do every film that JP Datta makes. And like I said, he's like border, he's different. He knows his job. He's fantastic with the camera. He's fantastic with... He's just too good. And that's the reason even today, 5 and 6 actors are willing to work with JP Datta together. I mean, no other maker can put together so many actors in one film. In today's time, it's very, very difficult. Some they might, but it's very, very difficult. And we're like a team. I mean, Sunny is like a brother to me. So is Aki and Puneet. And we're like a team. Nobody is bothered about whose role is bigger, whose role is smaller. Nothing. That's not what we're interested in. I mean, the entire team, Biguda, Chino, you know, we have 2 different fight directors in it. 2 brothers who are behaving like brothers, working like brothers. So it's just a team. And I feel great being a part of it.
You're almost like an army.
Yeah, we are an army. Exactly. We are an army.
Tell me, I mean, do you have any memories of wartime? I mean,
absolutely nothing. Absolutely nothing. Because I was too young then, and I don't remember anything. Like I said, I've only seen the good side of life. And it's only thanks to these people that I have seen the good side of life. Which is what I realize today. And
Which people?
The army. The men. I mean, the men who are guarding every post, every pillar. Day in and day out. Well, whereas we are doing our own thing, you know, enjoying life, the luxuries of life and everything else. And yeah, they're not getting their due, and I hope everybody realizes and, you know, something does work out.
Coming back to the almost the last on a lighter side, while you have you've worked with a lot of your co-stars, and like you said, you've been with them for the last 25 days, etc. And the general impression, what I get to hear is that you do pull a lot of it's been a lot of fun in games. And
yeah, that only shows how close we are, because nobody gets offended, nobody feels bad, we're having fun, we're like a team, and you don't fool around, you can't work. I mean, you need that kind of laughter to get you through every day and, you know, every routine. I used to do a lot of fooling around, but now Mr. Tinu Varma has come and he's taken over. So it's Tinu Ji who's entertaining all of us, and he's the head of the pranksters now. And so you've been watching, you've covered, and you know.
I believe you went to the actual physical border.
Yes, I did, and that was one of the most awesome sights, because I could see barbed wires as far as my eyes could. There were lights, there were the BSF force that was guarding them. They were extremely nice to us. We opened the borders, we walked through, went to the post, actually stepped on, you know, the other soil, and I had goosebumps all over me. Suddenly I felt ki, you know, this border means so much. And at the same time, there is no difference. I mean, it is one land, it looks the same. Everything is the same. But yet, this border had created a kind of difference between two countries, which I feel should never be there, because I've met people from all over the world and all in different places, and we and the other people feel the same, think the same, and everything. So, you know, it is sad, but because of a few individuals, there had to be a partition, and today we are two separate countries. But that feeling, that the goosebumps when I, that division, okay, this is India, this is Pakistan, left me with a very, you know, hurt feeling. Ki everything is one, but yet this partition has been created by God knows and shouldn't be there.
So in effect, what you're saying is, while it's a war story, it's actually an anti-war story.
Yeah, it is. Yeah. And at the same time, gives you a feeling of being a proud Indian. I mean, you know, what happened this that night, which we are reenacting, is very, very proud. I mean, definitely proudly Indian, and that is why we're doing everything to try and make this film reach every nook and corner of the world. We're working on, you know, products that we want every individual to have on their body, saying proudly Indian. You know, we want that feeling. We want, because that patriotic feeling is somewhere lacking in us. You know, we are always saying ki, nahi yaar, ye theek nahi hai apne udhar, wo theek nahi hai, ye theek nahi hai, wo theek nahi hai. I think this film and what has happened will make us feel proud about our men, our people, and us being Indians. It's not just the World Cup, the winning of the World Cup that should make us feel proud, but the winning of this battle and what every soldier has done here. Of course, every 100 Sachin hits is a proud feeling for us, a great feeling for us. But likewise, every life given here should give us 10 times more feeling. And hopefully this film should do it.